Hello everyone, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Merina Gartika. I'm staff in pediatric dentistry, dentistry faculty, Universitas Padjadjaran, Bandung, Indonesia. I would like to present my article that has published in International Journal of Research. Science and research. Okay, let's share the point PowerPoint.
The title of my article is Oral Hygiene Level of Down Syndrome Children in Bandung City. This is my abstract. As an introduction, Down syndrome is a genetic abnormality as a result of complete or partial copy of 3 chromosome 21. Down syndrome was firstly identified in 1866 by John Langdon Down as the most general cause of mental retardation. At first, this syndrome was thought as Mongolian because this syndrome shows typical form of face with narrow eyes like the Mongolian. Down syndrome is oftenly found malformation syndrome. The incidence was about 600 until 1,000 birth. 45 years old mother might higher the incidence to one of every 30 births. Estimated total number of Down syndrome patients in 2030 was 8.5 million all over the world. About 3,000 until 5,000 Down syndrome children were born every year. One of the family members of about 215,000 families in the United States had Down syndrome. In Indonesia, as reported by Riskesdas or Riset Kesehatan Dasar, the percentage of Down syndrome patients in Indonesia was 0.12% in 2010 and increased to 0.13% in 2013. POTAS is Down syndrome Parents Foundation reported there were about 300,000 Down syndrome cases in Indonesia. Down syndrome children have many characteristics like certain physical characteristics, mild to moderate mental retardation that causes difficulties for them to care for themselves, retarded psychomotor development, and general health problems. There are some oral manifestation of Down syndrome patients, which are dental and oral hygiene problems, mostly poor. A good oral hygiene is an important factor in having optimal condition of dental and oral health. Poor oral hygiene that is marked by plaque and calculus might cause periodontal disease. Other oral manifestation on Down syndrome children are macroglossia, tongue fissure, maxillary hyperplasia, tongue thrusting, congenital missing of the tooth, malocclusion, high palatal arch, increased rate of the saliva and pH, and also macrodontia. The aim of this research was to find out the level of oral hygiene of Down syndrome in Kota Bandung. Next is a method. The type of this research was a descriptive. Ethical clearance was approved by the Ethical Health Research Committee of the Medical Faculty Universitas Padjadjaran. Population was Down syndrome children aged 6 until 18 years in School of Handicapped Children in Indonesia, Sekolah Luar Biasa in Bandung. The subject was collected through multi-stage cluster sampling. All subjects were given informed consents to be filled and signed by their parents or guardians. The examination of oral hygiene level was done in accordance with the Oral Hygiene Index Simplified, OHIS, by Green and Vermilion, by dripping the disclosing solution under the patient's tongue. Result. This study about the level of oral hygiene on Down syndrome children was held in a school for handicapped children in Bandung. The subject was 30 Down syndrome children, consisted of 18 males and 12 females of 7 until 18 years old. The characteristic of subjects based on gender and age is shown in Table 1. Table 1 shows the characteristic of the subject based on gender and age that were consisted of 18 males and 12 females. Based on gender, the comparison of male and female subject was 3 to 2 ratio. Which means the total amount of male Down syndrome children was higher than female. Down syndrome occurs more often on males as a result of meiosis disturbance of the father that might influence the sex chromosome or higher accessibility of the sperm towards the ovary. While bringing the chromosome Y during fertilization, which then resulted in more Down syndrome children to be born male. Studies on the prevalence of Down syndrome based on gender were done in several countries such as Uchida in Canada 1970, the instant study in Sweden 1981, Bishop et al. In California 1997 and Sien et al. In United States 2009. All of the studies found that Down syndrome occurred more on males compared to females. The subject Plaque index was examined using Oral Hygiene Index Simplified by Green and Vermilion. The result is shown in Table 2. The Table 2 shows most of the subject, 63.33% was Down syndrome children with poor criteria of plaque index. This was similar with the study by Bradley and McAllister in Ireland in 2004 that found 50% Down syndrome had poor criteria. Other study by Kumar et al. In Udaipur in 2009 found 77% Down syndrome had poor criteria of plaque index. Poor plaque index might occur as a result of lacking optimal care of dental and oral hygiene. Plaque forming should be prevented or minimized by plaque control as an attempt to avoid and remove the plaque accumulation of the tooth surface and gingiva. Plaque control could either be mechanically or chemically done. Mechanical control is more effective and easier to be done using the toothbrush. The most influencing factor in oral hygiene caries is the individual habit. To brush the teeth is simple and easy to do for a normal child, but not for handicapped children like Down syndrome. Down syndrome children have a mental retardation that makes it difficult for them to do the instruction in the right way. Down syndrome children also have motoric limitation that make their movement rigid and rough. In addition, they have difficulties to hold a thing such as a toothbrush when brushing the teeth. Down syndrome need their parents or guardians' help when they brush their teeth. This should be done continuously until they get adequate ability to do it by themselves. There are difficulties for the parents or guardians, such as the child reject to open their mouth longer, swallow the toothpaste, push the toothbrush with the tongue, and or too many movement. Hypotonia orofacial and macroglossia on Down syndrome children may also make difficulties in toothbrushing activity. Their big tongue may cover the occlusal and lingual surfaces on the lower jaw. This may become worse by the weak control of the muscles and causes inaccurate movement of the tongue and cheek. That would further cause the toothbrushing process not being able to eliminate the plaque optimally. Next table is the Kuss index of the subjects was examined using oral hygiene index simplified. Table 3 shows that most of the subjects, 86.7% was Down syndrome children with a moderate calculus index. This means that most of the subjects had low ability to carry their dental and oral hygiene. Plaque is closely related with the calculus, as the accumulated plaque on the oral cavity might have mineralization and form calculus. If the dental and oral hygiene is not well cared, then as the child grows older, the amount of calculus sedimentation will increase. Calculus forming could be prevented by cleaning existing plaques as soon as possible, and brushing the teeth is the effective way for this. Frank and Winter stated that electric toothbrush is effective to eliminate the plaque in handicapped children, such as children with Down syndrome. Some of Down syndrome children might feel disturbed by the sound of the brush, so the triple-headed toothbrush may be alternately used. This type of toothbrush will clean the plaque on the buccal, occlusal, and lingual areas, but not effectively on the interproximal areas. Interdental brush may be alternately used in flossing on dental on Down syndrome children, because a brush bristle will effectively remove the plaque on the interdental area, and it is easy to use. Table 4 show most of the subject, 60% were Down syndrome children with a poor criteria of oral hygiene. This was similar with a study by Ori Dugba in Nigeria in 2007 that 40% Down syndrome children had poor dental and oral hygiene. Other study by Halisa et al. In Malaysia in 2015 found that 87.5% Down syndrome children had poor dental and oral hygiene. Next, the last table. The rate of oral hygiene index of the subject is presented in table 5. Based on this result, the level of oral hygiene of the subject in the study was classified as poor. The value is 3.1. This result was similar with the study by Kumar et al. In Udaipur 2009. That found the index rate of dental and oral hygiene was 3.82. The factor influencing of oral hygiene of Down syndrome children is mainly the mental retardation, since it causes the children having difficulties to understand the instruction of how to take care of dental and oral hygiene independently. Other factors influencing the dental and oral hygiene in Down syndrome children is malocclusion. Crowding might result in food debris retention that is difficult to be cleaned. Food debris retention may become plaque, and if not cleaned for a long time, then calculus would be formed and the dental and oral hygiene would turn worse. Poor dental and oral hygiene of Down syndrome children may cause problems of the dental and oral health, such as caries and periodontal disease that need more treatment. Based on the information from the parents, they visit the dentist when there is a problem of the teeth. Two of the parents said that they were worried when their child must have general anesthesia on the treatment, so they delayed the visit. American Dental Association declared that the best visit to dentist is every 6 months. This will routinely keep the oral health, not only to have treatment for dental problems. A good cooperation between the parents and the dentist is needed to get a successful dental care of Down syndrome children. In dental treatment, usually Down syndrome children will act cooperatively. Dentists can use the same method used on the other child patient, like Teng Shou do. While sedation or general anesthesia will only be used for uncooperative children. The parents or guardian is suggested to stay near the Down syndrome children during the treatment to keep them cooperative in such a situation. And at the end, we can take the conclusion is based on the examination done in school for handicapped children in Bandung. It has been concluded that the oral hygiene of Down syndrome children in Bandung was in poor category. Our references, and thank you.
Okay, that concludes my presentation. I hope it will be useful for all, and thank you everyone. Bye bye.